Sir, but just hold on for a minute. Arnab, okay. I'm here to patiently answer all the questions you are raising and all the questions everybody is going to answer, ask me.
Just one point.
But I want you to... Sir, just hold on for a minute. I'm here to answer you.
It's an unusual question.
You may ask me any number of questions, but hold on. Please hold on for a minute.
Okay, one of you has to... One of you has to...
No, I want a request placed to...
I want to say because you're saying something, Nirmala. If BJP respected its elders, yesterday Narendra Modi made an hour-long speech. Hour-long speech, he could have, to the party workers, he did not make a comment about workers who heckled and abused Advani the day before. That is my question to you. I mean, so how do you say, so the message that's coming through is not that this is a party that respects its elders, but that the cadre wants the elders to just go away. So that is my question. How does this show any respect? Where does this happen that a veteran of the party is attacked in this way by party cadres?
Good point. Now you can respond to that. After that, Dr. Singhvi, coming to you for your question. Those are pictures of party leaders arriving at LK Advani's residence. Mm-hmm. So this whole 9 o'clock drama today is going on in full force. But the fact of the matter is this, that the BJP has not been able to offer Mr. Advani anything more tangible than a repeated appeal. Another question coming for you, Nirmala Sitharaman, you can take both after that. But the second question coming to you from Dr. Singhvi. Yes, Dr. Singhvi to Nirmala Sitharaman. Yes, please.
Two comments. I don't want to indulge in question answer, but two clear comments, and you could consider them as questions as well. Number one, there is in politics a system of chickens coming home to roost. When you are opportunistic and selective at a point of time, when you have created these satellites, as Mr. Advani did, perhaps for his selective opportunism at that time, he is now finding those chickens coming home to roost. He is finding those very people whom he did not chastise in the Goa of 12 years ago, whom he did not control, for perhaps that temporary gain, that temporary time. These have come full circle and have now defied him, disobeyed him and disowned him. Second point is, I wonder whether the BJP as a party with a difference, as a highly disciplined cadre-based party, is going to forget about the messenger, but look at the message and investigate into Mr. Advani's very important sentence in that letter, that there are people pursuing their individual agendas, and I am sure he was not referring to Mr. Modi, or at least Mr. Modi alone. So is the BJP going to identify those people and take action?
Who are these people? Who are these people who Advani is talking about? In the letter of Mr. Advani, he talks about leaders who are... Let me tell you, I no longer have the feeling that this is the same idealistic party created by Dr. Mukherjee, Pandit Deendayalji, Nanaji and Vajpayee, whose concern was the country and its people. In other words, the present-day leaders have no concern for the country and its people. Most of our leaders, most, he says, are concerned with just their personal agendas. In a majority of the leaders of the BJP, in other words, a majority of the leaders going to his residence right now are obsessed with their personal agendas. The current functioning of the party, the direction in which it is going, he deplores it. Nirmala Sitharaman, who are these leaders he's talking about?
Arnab, I wanted to ask you, 1 minute's intervention, allow me to give an intervention, you did not. So I will rightfully start from that. If your intention is to raise questions, and if your intention was to have me here to give answers, I like to fulfill that intention. But if your intention is to raise questions and leave it open and move to another question, I'll sit quiet and watch this show, where four people are asking questions about BJP. I'm here to give answers, but I'm not being permitted. So I'm sure you will be gracious enough to allow me to answer those three things which have already been raised.
Go ahead.
Sabha raised this point. Sabha raised this point that cadres, who went and protested in front of Advani's house, Modi ji did not, condemn or question. That's not true at all. The party as one has very clearly come out to say, we condemn, we disassociate ourselves, and in fact went to say that none of them who protested in front were from the BJP. I will raise a question as to who they were myself much before anyone can answer it, because we don't see anyone of our cadres there. And we've condemned this because we don't believe in this. One. Second, much before I really have to speak about responding to Dr. Singhvi, I will certainly have to say He's talking about chicken coming home to roost.
Yeah.
We are a party who respects our elders. We take them on board, and if there are difficulties, we talk out with them, we go and sit with them, we try to tell them in the larger interest of the party, please come over. We may do many things with our elders with due respects to them. We are not a party who locks up our leader into a bathroom and usurp leadership, which is exactly what the Congress did.
I'm not permitting this interruption.
If this debate is going on in this, I'll sit quiet, Arnab. This is not fair.
No.
Let me clear the three points which were raised, and after that, you may give opportunity to anybody
else.
She has already talked about Sitaraman.
Sitaram Kesari, she said. Okay.
Yeah.
I've said about Sitaram Kesari, who was locked in the bathroom and the leadership was usurped. That was one thing. And second, we also saw the way in which P.V. Narasimha Rao was handled by the Congress party. And today, they will be better off if they remain quiet.
You're the party with a difference.
Wait, Arnab, please. Arnab, let me just speak. This is no way. I'm sorry. You may have to hold on for a minute. I'll answer all your questions. But please hold on. The third part point. A party forgets its messenger. Must take the messages very seriously. You know, what Advani ji has been saying to us and how we will take it, and we'll respect his views, we'll go listen to him. We did that yesterday, we'll do it today, we'll do it later, tomorrow too. It's a party which brings a culture of listening to the elders and working with them. Are we being lectured by the Congress party as to how we have to take Advani ji's messages seriously? Suddenly, messages being given by Advani ji has become dearer to the Congress. He has said a lot of things about Congress. Have they paid heed to him? Suddenly, why they find his messages very, very interesting?
I think today the Congress should be better off. First of all, your intervention has been fairly detailed, and now you can't complain that I am not coming to you. Please, Nirmala Sitharaman.
Let me make a limited point
to you here today. Your unfortunate situation is that you have to choose between your oldest face and your most popular face. Your unfortunate thing is that if you buy peace with Advani and set up another committee under Mr. Gadkari so that Mr. Advani and the anti-Modi camp can continue their fight to another day, you will annoy Modi, you will trigger another crisis. Your unfortunate reality is then your party will appear even more than a divided house. But the bottom line is, what is most unfortunate for the BJP today is whatever option you choose Advani or you choose Modi, you lose your stalwart and most recognizable face, or you appear as a divided house, you will appear as a divided house, whatever option you choose. And when I said it yesterday, that look at the body language, I pulled those pictures out. I have never seen a more tense anointment, Nirmala Sitharaman. Yesterday, not today's pictures are tense, but yesterday's were extremely tense when the leadership came out to announce Mr. Narendra Modi's name. I'm sorry to say it, appeared as if a section of the BJP leadership was in mourning. A section of the BJP leadership appeared in mourning. They were tense. There were no celebrations. One of your leaders took the flight, went back. You denied all this. And that's what chickens are also coming home to roost, Nirmala. And, you know, being in denial is not a solution for you today. Being in denial is not a solution for you today. That's the only limited point. Kamal Farooqi wanted to respond to you.
Am I allowed to respond to your limited point, or I should listen to it and sit quiet?
No. You don't have to listen to it and sit quiet. You know, that's all right.
But I want to rebut it in a very, very quick answer.
I have been on the firing line of the BJP since yesterday. From Yashwant Sinha to every BJP spokesman has put me on the firing line.
Don't play victim, Arnab. You can never be in the firing line.
It was right. And what we reported was correct.
Arnab, kindly do not play victim. You can never be in the firing line anywhere. You are the media. You can question us, and we are here to answer you.
But what I want to tell you, please,
Mr. Kamal Farooqi, kindly allow me.
Mr. Farooqi wants to say something.
There has been a rebuttal from Arnab Goswami, which is a very, very interesting line. There was a sense of the body language showed mourning. I'm sorry. There was a celebration. You saw a lot of fireworks.
Allow me to speak, Arnab. You see, I'll play the pictures of yesterday when the name was being announced, okay? And then we'll find out whether those were fireworks or the most tense moment.
Oh, Arnab, hold on for a minute. If I understand technology right, when you start speaking, everybody else's voice gets subdued.
Then Nirmala Sitharaman, please complete your point, and then Kamal Farooqi wanted to come in, please. And by the way, there is no technology by which when I speak, everybody's voice gets subdued. I assure you, there is no such technology which has been invented till now. Nirmala Sitharaman, Abhishek Manu Singh, I'm coming to you in just a minute. So one second. Nirmala Sitharaman, please. Yes.
I just wanted to tell you that the interpretation and your understanding of the body language of the leaders who announced yesterday is not right. Because if it indeed was with a sense of mourning, we wouldn't have had firecrackers, drum beats, music and so on. So let's not read too much into that. But today, clearly,
Abhishek Singhvi, before Kamal Farooqi,
before Dr. Saab say, I just want to ask one thing. Abhishek bhai, just hold on for a minute, please. It is not simply a resignation letter. Please mind it. It is not a resignation letter. Even if he withdraws, even if they are in a position to cajole him, what will happen to the contents? He has raised certain very, very basic questions. Where are the answers for this question? Resignation or no resignation? Acceptance or not acceptance? Whatever they do, what is the answer to those questions which he has raised about the party?
Good point. But Abhishek Singhvi, because he has to go. Before I let Abhishek Manu Singhvi go, your...
No, Arnav, I want to only say this. First of all, you certainly have been made the victim as far as the BJP spokesperson is concerned, because for the last 10 minutes, this program was looking like only one between you and the BJP. And yet they were complaining about not being heard. Secondly,
obviously you're talking about Advani. What else completely. Will it be?
The point is being missed completely. You can keep abusing the Congress, and thank God till now, not even our worst BJP critic has suggested that the people demonstrating outside Advaniji's house were congressmen. I'm sure that's going to come tomorrow, but till now they haven't thought of it. That'll be an afterthought tomorrow. But keep abusing the Congress, but the point remains still that neither Mr. Narasimha Rao nor Mr. Sitaram Kesari wrote the letters, made the remarks or the comments which Messrs. Advani, Yashwant Sinha, Jaswant Singh, Shatrughan Sinha by word or conduct have made. And the real point is to react to them, not on your subjective interpretations of who treats who, how. We're not on treatment, we're not on age. We are on their specific clear comments which suggest that here is a party which is at the moment far from ready to even come to the battlefield, because they have a big war which has weakened them completely, which they are fighting, the end of which is nowhere in sight. That's the issue for the country. That's the question the country is asking. And there's no point abusing the Congress or other parties to get around that question. You have a whole generation of leaders speaking in one voice in the BJP. You have a whole group of other leaders speaking in a different voice. And here is a party you want the country to believe is going to be even fit to fight the election, much less lead them in the next government. That's the real relevant issue.